Hi, Wee Bob here, and this week we're going to be looking at a number of the major updates to Rebelle 6 and some of the cool features that have been added to Rebelle 6 since its launch in December 2022. So the current version of Rebelle 6 that I'm using is 6.1.3, and this just shows you how often they are making fixes and changes and providing a better quality product to the end user. Really quite appreciate the amount of effort that goes into this software. My new PC specifications are shown on the screen for those that want to know, and we will work through some of these updates and see how they perform on my new PC, and I'll give you some of the experience I had previously. So getting right into that, if we look at the Liquify tool, Liquify tool is a tool that I really love, and I've done a few videos on it. I did one full my favorite feature video, which I'll leave a link to at the end of this video. It will give you some ideas as to how you can use this tool and how to use it maybe in ways that you wouldn't have thought of before. So our canvas here is A4 and it is 300 dpi and it is working well. However, I do still experience some slowdown on the Liquify tool at large brush sizes. But for lower brush sizes, all is working really well. You can see as I use this enlarging Liquify tool, everything's working well without any lag, which to be fair, didn't seem to be an issue with my 10-year-old PC either, so not much difference with the kind of enlarging part of the tool. The real big change I have noticed is with the Twirl Liquify tool. So if you do watch one of those previous videos, you'll see I stop using the brush and you can still see the mathematics taking place. Now, it could be that the new version is better and the old version took more mathematics and therefore it's not to do with my PC. It could be that they've made big changes, which I know they have done, to help computers process these new features better. But regardless, Twirl's working fine. Really great feature again, just to get some abstract look to your work. Once we've done our liquifying effects, we can bake those effects. This is a new button that I don't remember seeing previously, and that means that you've done the liquifying you want to do, you bake that. You can no longer undo the liquify with some of the tools that are available to you. But this is really useful because it means you can then go on and add more liquifying effects to a baked liquify version of your drawing. But it's still possible to use Ctrl-Z or the normal undo, as you would normally do in your process. The warp tool is now working a heck of a lot better with my new PC. I'm able to manipulate the drawing, push things where I maybe want them to go, rather than the slowdown I got in my previous PC. So, really pleased, everything's working better. And there does need, appear to be some new features added to the warp tool, in the form of when you split some of the canvas, you can now make a split so that it doesn't look quite as weird as it did before. Not sure I would use this tool, maybe I'm misunderstanding how to use it, but it seems to be new and added into the features. So just as a quick aside, if you're purchasing Rebelle or looking to purchase new equipment, please check out the affiliate links in the description below. It really does help out my channel and it helps me buy the few wee bits and bobs that I've put in, microphones and various things. But thank you anyway. Regardless, thank you for watching and thank you for doing all the other bits and bobs like liking and so on and so forth. But the next feature we are going to see updates to, or we have seen updates to, is the reference image guides. So reference image guides, again, another a fantastic feature of Rebelle, which has helped me immensely from the point of view of measuring references and getting eyes in the correct position, getting noses where they should be, bottom of noses, without having to measure on a screen, which I struggled with and have struggled with ever since starting digital art. How do you measure to get your initial foundation of your drawing? And this tool really has helped. But it's now much easier to use with the addition of an extra button to turn on and off the guides as they appear on this canvas. Previously, we would have had to go through menus to achieve the same result. But as a quick tip, if you do want different sizes and colours of image reference guides, you will find this in the options menu, which you go to through Edit, Preferences, then the color menu, then scroll down to the bottom of the dialog box and you'll see here that you can make some changes to the width, the color, and it makes it easier to use, and we can turn them on and off and we can do all the features that I've showed you previously in my 24-minute introduction to Rebelle 6. So that is the update to the reference image guides. One thing I would say as well is that you can now delete the reference image guides, the guides on the image that you've made, just by hovering over it. It turns a different colour, and you can use your keyboard, hit the delete button, and it will disappear. We now have new filters and curves, which can give us greater control over the final look, the final colour, the final values that appear in our piece of artwork. We can also get some nice effects from using these tools if we use them to the extreme. So we just double click on a curve to add a handle that allows us to manipulate the curve in a more controlled way. We can choose the individual RGB channels, can't speak, and again use this to get the colour look for our final piece. So if we want to remove all the reds, we can do that. Or you can just do various things, from making multiple pieces. You can make a warm version of your drawing and a cold version of your drawing, if that's what we're trying to achieve. The filters again now work flawlessly on my new PC, whereas previously these filters were taking many seconds, if not more than a minute sometimes, to respond. The sharpening tool from memory was really, really slow, now almost instantaneous. I've been doing a lot of experimenting this weekend with watercolour washes and trying to mimic real life, trying to get look at a video, see how somebody does it in real life, and then mimic that in Rebelle 6. And still struggling a wee bit with it, to be honest. I put some of that in my watercolour video again. There's many videos on my channel covering many of these topics, and I don't want to keep going over the same ground all over and all over again. So please check out the other videos to see more details on watercolour. But to achieve the results, I have had to use a blending brush, and Rebelle seem to have recognised this in some way or other. They've put in this option that you can, as soon as you've used a wet media brush, so that would be your oils, your watercolours, and your fountain pen type tools, it will go from being paint and blend, it'll go to just the blending brush, which is what I've been using, because people seem to be finding that that is the most natural way to get a similar traditional type result. I think I'm going to cover that in a future video, looking at how, as you can see on the screen, this wash, how did I get to that nice smooth transition between the colours, because it wasn't as easy as I think maybe it should have been. And I do have some ideas for Rebelle and for Escape Motions to maybe sort that out, which would really help, being able to turn on and off the water wall, as I would call it, that happens when you put in just slightly too much water. Again, I'll perhaps cover that in a future video. So we now have the capability to create a layer mask from a selection. So if I just want to see my face here that I've drawn alone and add some cool layered mask type effects, we can do this as shown on the screen. And I really do like layer masks. It's not something that I use a lot, but I do like them when I use them, and I think, oh, I should remember to use these, and then I forget. So anyway, hopefully you've found out some new things that you may not have seen in Rebelle 6, and hopefully you've just enjoyed listening along to the video. Maybe I've taught you a thing or two. If not, thank you anyway for watching. It's very much appreciated. Cheers, and Wee Bob is out.